Hello and welcome to the, I guess, the first real episode of this Project City. Like I mentioned in the last episode, I am beginning the building of this city from the real life Tampere suburbs called Hervanta. And as you can see, here we are jumping straight into the time lapse or speed build. Beginning with the highway connection. As for the road layout, I'm creating just the bare essentials at this point, and I'll keep expanding the roads as I build the suburbs. I do have an idea of the road layout, but I'm trying not to be too strict with it. I'd rather evolve it as I go along. I will be making a lot of progress in the first few episodes so that I can get my budget balanced and can move to work on the actual city center. This episode actually took a lot longer to finish than I planned, mainly because I've been so busy for the past 2 weeks, but I'm already making the next episode and try to put out one episode per week. From the building I've done, beyond of what this episode covers, I already know that I need to enable the infinite money mod. I know that I said in the last episode that I don't play with infinite money, but it seems that the infrastructure service and especially the blobable Rico buildings, they do gobble up all of my money pretty fast. So I will definitely change to infinite money in the next episode, and I will keep that on or enabled until I see a healthy positive income. Otherwise the lack of money will just create too much of a drag on the building process. So the first thing to build is the roundabout. What else? But really I would have used a regular intersection here instead of the roundabout, but I'm expecting the industrial traffic coming through here to be quite heavy. This straight bit of highway will in the future continue and make another connection to the Helsinki-Tampere highway, so this roundabout will become a major intersection at some point. Thank you. there was some building I did off camera because I accidentally forgot to record them, like the pedestrian paths and bicycle lanes in the roundabout. You can see them on this cinematic of the road layout. These suburbs are very plain looking and even ugly, and most of the housing is old concrete tenement blocks set in a something of a grid pattern. This is pretty much the look of the real Hervanta, which I am told was inspired by Le Corbusier. But there's really nothing glamorous here. It's just a bunch of cheap housing quickly put together for the growing population of Tampere in the late 1970s and early 80s. The tenements I'm using here are from a Soviet tenement collection, but we have plenty of the same type of concrete element houses here in Finland as well. Pretty much any of the detailing you see me doing in these first episodes is not final. I will redo at least some of it later. At this stage, I am more concerned getting most of the roads and pedestrian and bicycle paths in place. It also always takes me some time to figure out what kind of detailing look works and what doesn't. So usually the older parts of my cities gets redone or reworked once I know the look I want. Also the LUT, map theme, lighting and so on will all probably change between the next couple of episodes. It's all very difficult to pin them down before you have any roads or buildings placed. It's only when you can see the effects on the surroundings, you can start to realize how you want the map to look. Making a small commercial block here, a couple of small shops and a little grocery store where the surrounding neighborhood can walk to. There will be a larger supermarket and a shopping center in the heart of this suburb. But for most of the Sims, that will be too far to walk to, and they need to go by car or public transport. Normally you would visit a large supermarket only a couple of times per week and do your small shopping in these small neighborhood groceries. I am also considering here the school service radius and placing a elementary school and a clinic to serve the eastern side of the suburbs. That clinic is in fact a rehab center in Helsinki, but it works as a clinic in this game. I like the look of it, especially since it looks a little out of place in the midst of all that, all those concrete blocks around it. Thank you. decided to place this newer housing development here, but I'm not happy with it, so I will redo it once I have expanded the area around it a little bit. Right, so I'm continuing with the service buildings and plopping down a high school for the east side of the suburbs. And next to that will be a small university building I found in the workshop. This university building only has capacity for 300 students or something like that, and it is a kind of detached department of the actual city university. I need some sort of university education over here in the suburbs, because there is a police academy in Hervanta, which I want to recreate. I'm planning on using office buildings for that, and I do need to educate my Sims to fill the workplaces in the offices. There's plenty of things to consider when you want your city to work as per the game mechanics, while trying to maintain some degree of realism to the build. Eastern side of these suburbs, which I'm building now, will gradually turn into a industrial area the further it extends from the center I started building from. I don't own the industries DLC, so all of the industrial buildings will just be generic or manufactories or so on. There is also a power transform station and a water treatment plant situated in the industrial area. I use a couple of workshop assets for power source and sewage treatment. They do cost me money, but do not put out any pollution. But I will get back to them later. I also use no power lines mode, basically because most of the power lines in urban areas in Finland run all underground. Only the high voltage transfer lines are visible above ground, and those I will probably recreate when I build the city power plant. And as far as the city power plant goes, that is another thing why I don't want to place the usual power stations in this game. There would be a lot of them for a city of this size needed. And in Finland, like many other countries, there is a national power grid from which the electricity is taken. So the power station or power plant, which actually is providing the electricity for a city, might not be the one in that city. There usually is a power plant in of some sort situated in the outskirts of larger cities in Finland, but they really are not responsible for providing the electricity of the city they are residing in. In fact, the very idea that your city in this game should be self-sufficient with its workplaces and production chains and power sources and so on is in my opinion very childish and silly. I think the outside connections in the map should really provide much more than just road traffic. I mean, for example, your citizens might commute to the nearby city if your city doesn't have enough workplaces available, and vice versa. And same, of course, goes for the electricity. Thank you. I'm doing here is a small sport center and park area, partly belonging to the schools next door and some of the buildings being commercial, like gyms and outdoor and indoor tennis courts and so on. I decided to place a recycling center next to the sport park and hide it with trees. This is how we mostly do things here in Finland. We tend to hide all the eyesores in thick woods. So you might not even know you are next to a dump yard if you can't see it from the ground level. Okay, so this is the power transform station, which I mentioned earlier. I'm building it with just minimal assets to give it a look of something going on. I would of course love to use the many power station assets there are in the workshop, but since this suburb is just kind of a sideshow, I don't really want to do too much detail here. I will rather or prefer to save the major detailing to the actual city and to the places where or which will feature in the cinematics. I'm using the Transforum or Transfororum, I'm not sure what the name was, which is the small building with the pointy roof. It creates a little bit of power, but the good thing about it is that because it's so small, it can be hidden inside other buildings. So you can build a power station of your liking, basically, and just stuff these things in there and it will create power. The other good thing about this building is that you can, by using it, you can increase the power output incrementally. So you don't need to place a huge power station every time you are running out of electricity. Thank you. And next to the transform station goes the water treatment plant, a asset which I basically use in all of my cities. As you can see, it's not very realistic or pretty looking, but it gets the job done. It doesn't create any pollution, and it has a pretty good capacity. I'm just adding some props here to make it look the part a little more. I might actually come back to this plant later and perform a facelift on it. I might need to place another one somewhere. So this could be a good plant to just copy to another place. So, yes, this water treatment plant will conclude the building for this episode. There is a couple of minutes of cinematics in the end, but they are rather static since there are no inhabitants in the city yet. So, that is all for now, and thank you for watching, and please check in on the next episode. Like I said, there will be many changes coming to the look and feel of this map. So I'll see you next time. Bye bye.